reason, this is some music I can get into. And it looks like...
Well, the reason why Referee Hansen isn't here tonight is because he's on tour again.
I had to go perform. And they're getting the crowd to clap along. I mean, it's not my job to sing it. It costs a little extra. But there they are! Generation Me.
381 pounds. The team of Mexican Germany. Generation Me.
Generation Me, who's been taking TNA by storm since their debut back in January with that upset victory over the Motor City Machine Guns. They made quite a name for himself on the independent scene, known as the Young Bucks. But Jeremy and Max debuting in Jersey All-Pro Wrestling in a matchup, Sam, that could easily touch the ceiling.
It absolutely could. You want to talk about a flight fest? This is it. I mean,
music.
It's no coincidence that Generation Me went to the same type score that the Rockers did.
But we as entertainers have a responsibility to these kids. Sorry.
If I were to die murdered in cold blood tomorrow, would you feel sorry, show love, or would it matter? Could never be the leadoff batter. Everything shit for me to feed off. I'm seesaw battling, but there's way too much.
And there he is.
And a combined weight of 363 pounds, the team of Jack Evans and Teddy Hart.
Jack Evans teaming with the Manu and May. We learned tonight we'll be facing Juice and Thunder Liger, Teddy Hart.
Teddy Hart and Jack Evans, 5 years ago in Philadelphia, at the very first caged hearing, upset Homicide and B-Boy in Philadelphia, and became the Jersey All-Pro Wrestling Tag Team Champions. Tonight, they take on Max and Jeremy of Generation Me. In the first half of our double main event here tonight at Wild Card 6 in the night that saw Charlie Haas return to Jersey All-Pro Wrestling and become the New Jersey State Champion. In the night where Bandido Jr. survived four other challengers in the Insane Flight Fest to retain the Light Heavyweight Championship. In a night that saw Sarah Del Rey and Haley Hatred put women's wrestling on the map in Jersey All-Pro Wrestling and go all over the Rahway Recreation Center, we will see a truly historic high-flying tag team matchup between the Hart Foundation, the New Hart Foundation, and Jeremy and Max, Generation Me.
Well, Teddy Hart was just up in the crowd saying hello to all the fans, and it is always an event when Teddy Hart returns to a Jersey All-Pro Wrestling ring.
Last time he was here was exactly a month after Christmas, and how nice of it was it that he wished everybody a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year?
Yes. I mean, a month late, but better late than never. I didn't get any Christmas card from you, Clemson.
Only about a week or so from Greek Orthodox Christmas, so maybe he's Greek.
Maybe he is. You don't know. Maybe that's not in your little notes, is it?
No, I didn't ask. Teddy Hart and Jack Evans lost their matchup at the 12th anniversary show against the Briscoe brothers, trying to gain a measure victory here tonight against Generation Me.
Thank God for dancing. And it looks like Mbop was not enough to get the crowd behind Generation Me, as just about all the crowd has chosen Jack Evans as Teddy Hart as their favorites tonight.
Well, Teddy Hart has always been an enigma here in Jersey All-Pro Wrestling ever since he started in February of 2004. It was that revolution, the very first matchup between him and Homicide. Teddy Hart was hated on the internet. But when he comes to Jersey All-Pro Wrestling, the fans just love him. And they love when they do the flips. It's amazing. He just has the crowd in the palm of his hands.
Well, the thing about Teddy Hart is you never quite know for sure which is the real Teddy Hart. He comes out here and says a lot of nice things about the promotion, about the fans. He shakes hands with Generation Me, said they were the best team. But is he just trying to lure them, to give them a sense of false confidence in him?
Maybe, but Teddy Hart, a few years ago, no-show Jersey All-Pro Wrestling for two straight events. He comes back for the third, and the fans just, they forgave him like nothing ever happened. So, it's just, again, it's surprising how Teddy Hart has the crowd in the palm of their hands. But will it work here tonight against Generation Me? It's Max in the ring right now against Teddy Hart.
Well, I mean, no matter how much you hate Teddy Hart, it's just it becomes impossible to argue with his in-ring performance. And to have Jack Evans as his tag team partner was another one who you can't dislike because his in-ring performance is so entertaining on a daily basis. Every time he gets in that ring, he entertains the crowd. And no matter what he says, you have to forgive him. But now it's time for Generation Me to prove that they can be just as entertaining, just as dominating, and just as victorious.
We're seeing four athletes in the prime of their careers right now. Teddy Hart, arguably one of the most controversial wrestlers on the planet today just through his antics. Jack Evans tearing up the ring in Mexico. Generation Me debuting in TNA and just taking that by storm. So just like the international matchup between Samoa Joe and Okada, what a treat for Jersey All Pro Wrestling seeing Teddy Hart and Jack Evans versus Generation Me.
Well, we saw Samoa Joe victorious in his match. Will Generation Me be able to continue the streak and get another victory for the TNA superstars that are visiting us tonight? Keep in mind, after this match, we still have a world title match, and Dan Moff has no idea who he's facing.
That is correct. Dan Moff in the main event here tonight will defend the Jersey All-Pro Wrestling Heavyweight Championship, but against who? But that matchup is next right now. Teddy Hart just taking it to Max Buck of Generation Me.
I mean, technically, Max Buck could be Dan Moff's opponent.
Yeah, I mean, anybody could challenge Dan Moff. It could be Teddy Hart. It could be Jack Evans. It could be one of the members of Generation Me. That's just what the intrigue of Wild Card brings to this event here in Jersey All-Pro.
And Teddy Hart has been fairly dominating thus far in this match. And Jack Evans not going for the tag. Teddy Hart going for the rope break. Big shot to the midsection.
Max just rams Teddy Hart's head into that top turnbuckle. Max, 4 years older than his brother Jeremy. They started, they trained each other in backyard wrestling. They even opened up their own promotion in California called High Risk Wrestling. That's where they got their names. They were then scouted by the SoCal group Pro Wrestling Guerrilla. They were on national TV for the National Wrestling Alliance on the Maverick Network. Now they're in TNA tearing up the soundstage in Universal Studios in Florida. And tonight, they're trying to do the same for Jersey All-Pro Wrestling. Jack Evans off the ropes, stayed on his feet, but Jeremy got the kick to the sternum.
Well, it looks like Jeremy's spoken, and what he said is he is ready for Jack Evans. It's a Pearl Jam song.
I love that song.
I'm sure you do. You relate to it.
Max now gets the tag, comes off the top with a double axe handle right to the clavicle of Jack Evans in a quick tag. Jeremy, once again, the legal man off the top, and a stomp now to the shoulder and the elbow and the wrist of Jack Evans.
Those two boots came down from about 15 feet in the air right on the arm of Jack Evans, and a moonsault to his arm.
Teddy Hart coming in the ring, distracting referee Johnny Q, but this is now the game plan of Generation Me, the quick tags, working on the arm of Jack Evans. Look at that. Nice athleticism, a drop kick at the end, and now Max just throws Jeremy over his head and a drop kick on Jack Evans and Generation Me, Sam Roberts, in sound control of the match.
Generation Me has their teamwork down to a science. And I mean, let's face it, even the best tag teams have been teaming, what, 10 years? 15 years. Generation Me has been teaming all their life. They're brothers.
Pretty much. Two of three brothers that compete in professional wrestling. Oh, but Jack Evans trying to take on both members of Generation Me. Leaps over and gets the tag. Here comes Teddy Hart, comes off the top. Almost fell, but got the clothesline on Jeremy and one for Max.
Oh, down goes Jeremy. And the third member of Generation Me, the third brother, would be out here, but he's a midget wrestler. That's why he doesn't team with them.
I don't think that's the case, but... And fast pace action here. Teddy Hart and Jeremy going at it in the corner. Football tackle. And Teddy Hart now going for that spike pile driver. No arm. Spike pile driver in the ropes. And Jeremy is down to the floor. And quite possibly, Sam, could be out of this match.
And it's moves like that that make it impossible not to like Teddy Hart. To make it undeniable how good he is as he powerbombs him down on his knees. Incredible.
The back cracker powerbomb by Teddy Hart on Max. And you hear the crowd here in Rahway at the top of their lungs chant for the self-professed savior of professional wrestling, Teddy Hart.
The only problem with a move like that is that kind of impact, as bad as it's going to hurt Generation Me, it's going to hurt Teddy Hart's knees. I mean, to drop a man across your knees from that height, it's going to hurt.
Jack Evans kicking Jeremy. Jeremy again down to the floor, and it's a double team action here by the Hart Foundation on Max. Jack Evans going on the shoulders of Teddy Hart, trying to hold on as best he can, leaps off his partner, and it's stopped right to the sternum. Max was hanging out on that middle turnbuckle, and Jack Evans leaping off his partner's shoulders with that moonsault stomp on Max.
Into the corner he goes.
Generation Me.
As Teddy Hart is now preparing to do even more damage. Bringing him up.
Teddy Hart now, cross arm, pile driver. Spike pile driver by Teddy Hart. Max isn't moving, and the Hart Foundation in control here, and the crowd in Rahway loving every second.
Teddy Hart taking a moment to show off that physique. I mean, I guess if you have a physique that you work as hard on as Teddy Hart does, you're going to want to show it off.
More power to him, I guess. And again, the Hart Foundation continuing the double team onslaught on Max of Generation Me. Wow, look at that. A suplex into a almost 450 splash by Jack Evans. The agility by Jack Evans
really
is just remarkable.
And the way Jack Evans can use Teddy Hart and vice versa to pull off some of these exquisite moves. It looks as though Jack Evans gets his move. A lot of his moves come from his experience as a breakdancer. He's found ways to set himself up for dance moves, but turn it into a wrestling move. Maybe that's something some of those strippers or the Osirian Portal or something to figure out.
Maybe. You think he learned how to use that type of offense in the Hart family dungeon? Jack Evans, a part of the last class ever in the dungeon with Teddy Hart, Tyson Kidd, and D.H. Smith.
Yeah, he was breakdancing all over Stu. God rest his soul.
I don't know about that. Nice body throw by Teddy Hart. Goes for the cover. And Jeremy needs to do something, because if Max continues to take the brunt of this offense by Teddy Hart and Jack Evans, this matchup will be over sooner than later.
And the referee, it looks like Jack Evans was coming in to help his partner. The referee quick to remove him, but not quick enough. It gave Evans and Hart the advantage one more time as Jack Evans now comes to the ring.
Get up, Jeremy!
Look out.
Oh, and they'll give it up for that.
Standing corkscrew moonsault, and again Jeremy comes in and breaks up the count. Jack Evans is just amazing. He stood on the chest of Max, hit that corkscrew moonsault,
and off the top rope and down he goes.
A cutter from the top rope. Max flipping around in midair, grabbed the head of Jack Evans and just buried it down to the mat. And now Max, desperate crawling, makes the tag. Here comes Jeremy trying to get some offense on Generation Me, and caught Teddy sleeping in the corner.
Big drop kick sends Teddy sailing into the guardrail, and a chop across Jack Evans. Jeremy, does he catch him? Yes, down neck breaker.
Hangman's neck breaker in the corner, and spike DDT by Jeremy. This could be what Generation Me needs to gain control in this matchup.
Sending elbows into Teddy Hart's head. Down goes Teddy, out the ring.
Whoa!
And I gotta ask you this, what do you think Generation Me keeps in the pocket of their tights?
I don't really want to know. But Teddy Hart goes hard out to the floor. Jeremy with that baseball slide again on Teddy. Jeremy could be Teddy Hart's worst nightmare, as well as Jack. Look at that!
He's hitting Jack, then he's hitting Teddy, then he's hitting Jack, then he's hitting Teddy, then he's hitting Jack, then he's hitting Teddy. I don't know where this guy gets it from.
Oh! A miscalculation by Generation Me. Max hit his brother, Jack Evans, with that flippity flip move off the ropes. Oh, and that's standing. Corkscrew 450 splash, but Max kicks out.
Jack Evans does these moves that most wrestlers couldn't even do off the top rope, standing on the mat.
Exactly. What an athlete, Jack. Oh! Spear by Jeremy. And a double team maneuver there by Generation Me. Teddy Hart comes and breaks it up. And now Jeremy and Teddy once again fighting. I've never seen anybody besides Homicide have the number of Teddy Hart as much as Jeremy's having in this matchup.
Oh, he's going for some kind of Frankensteiner, and Teddy Hart picked him back up.
Maybe not. Teddy Hart with a headbutt. And now Captain Crunch DDT by Teddy Hart on Jeremy. But Max right there following up.
I honestly thought only dogs were named Max.
I guess not. Max comes coming in. Teddy Hart has him, and again a corkscrew into a stunner by Teddy Hart. But, and you notice, Sam, though, the momentum, the pace of this matchup has slowed down considerably since the beginning of the match.
Well, I mean, that's a key thing in the match. If you start fast, you better be ready to end it fast, because you're not going to be able to hold up a pace like that for the entire match, as Teddy Hart just got kicked in his chin. He may be out cold.
Max telling Teddy to get up to his feet. Max just measuring up the savior. Oh. Teddy Hart blocked that elbow. Kick to the sternum here. And another back cracker. Second time in the matchup. Jack Evans quickly springboards up to the ring apron, comes off the top rope. A senton on Max when he was just laying on top of the knees of Teddy Hart. Jeremy comes in, and the last split second breaks up the count.
Barely broken up. That was almost a three count. And like we said before, Generation Me certainly knows how to work together as a team.
Now trading elbows in the center of the ring are Jack Evans and Jeremy. Oh, look out. Jeremy spinning him around and hit that kick right to the side of the head, and a savate kick. Multiple kicks by Generation Me into a German suplex. Nice power, and Teddy breaks it up. Wow, how about this Generation Me? Just one move, and a split second later, the other hits the move, then a split second later, the other one. It's like clockwork.
It is. This crowd was so firmly behind Teddy Hart and Jack Evans when this match started, but I think Generation Me has done a sensational job of winning them over. As the crowd chants, "This is awesome," they just love both teams now. They just love watching this match.
Teddy Hart up to his feet. Decides to go out to the floor and turn his attention to Jeremy. And Teddy Hart climbing the ropes. Look out. Had his back turned. Hit the moonsault and took out Jeremy. Meanwhile, we got Max and Jack Evans with the back body slide into a bridge. Whoa. And Max barely able to kick out. Jacked up that clothesline and just kicked him right in the face.
That looked like something out of the Matrix.
And after moves like this, it's no wonder that Jack Evans is tearing up the ring in Mexico. Again, this guy is just an unbelievable athlete. Teddy Hart has Jeremy over his shoulder. Jack leaps off of Jeremy. Oh, but he got met with the knees by Max.
And it looks like Generation Me has regained control. It's so hard to tell who's...
Jeremy took out Teddy Hart, and now off the top.
They got him, Clemson, they got him.
Generation Me with the crazy dive.
Gentlemen, your winners, the team of Max and Jeremy Jenner. Generation Me.
The crazy dive and then right in to more bang for your buck. And wow, Generation Me victorious here over Teddy Hart and Jack Evans, Sam Roberts. That was one hell of a match.
Incredible showing for both teams. And Generation Me just completely won this crowd over. A standing ovation for Generation Me and the performance they put forth tonight. And the crowd is now liking Mbop.
I guess so after that matchup. The final sequence by Generation Me in the matchup was called More Bang for Your Buck. And I can see why, and that was enough to put Teddy Hart and Jack Evans away.